Hello, you fabulous people. It's Tea Time with Tia. Today, I am going to discuss an amazing trip I had. I went to the first city of Corinth, had a wonderful conversation with some Corinthians on 10th Street and the 13th home. So I visit 1 Corinthians 10 and 13 today. We talked about temptation. This is a very serious and a hot topic. The problem is that some people come into the faith of Jesus Christ and they were pretty much explained that it was going to be a bed of roses and a peaches and cream lifestyle. Unfortunately, that is not the truth. How do we know? Well, the first and perfect and only perfect couple that was created as mature adults, Adam and Eve, fell into temptation. The rest of us were not born in a perfect state. We were born in an imperfect state. We must overcome temptation, but we cannot do it alone. We have a free will. Yes, we can make up our own minds that we're not going to do certain things, and that's good. But however, temptation for the believing Christian, you know, gets a little more complicated than that, because the enemy does have different tactics that he uses to try and trip up the believer in Christ. Well, this is what Paul said to the Corinthians. From what they shared with me, he told them, therefore now there is no temptation, but such is common to man. But God is faithful, who will not suffer you to be tempted above that which you are able, but will with the temptation make a way of escape that you may be able to bear it. With that being said, Baptist people, it's important to understand that we overcome by the blood of the Lamb, which is the blood that Jesus shed on the cross for our sins, and by the word of our testimony. We are overcome by one another's testimony. It does help us. So I would like to know your testimony. If you don't mind commenting below, I would love to hear your story. Until the next time you sit with me, God bless you and enjoy your tea.